Father, we're going to be talking about the Holy Spirit and suffering. What's the connection there in your mind?
Well, I think we've all heard that expression, you know, when one door slams and the Holy Spirit is opening another door, or maybe several other doors of opportunity, sometimes even before we're aware that the suffering has taken hold, those doors of opportunity are being opened by the Holy Spirit. And so there's just a few little techniques that we can sort of bear in mind about how the Holy Spirit guides us through the times of suffering into new opportunities. Sometimes our suffering can really be, losing somebody who is beloved in our lives. Other times the suffering can be really, a loss of some kind of power, perhaps our eyesight or our ambulatory ability or whatever it may be. Sometimes the suffering can be a loss of job or things going wrong with our children or something of that nature. But normally, when there's suffering going on, when doors are closing, the Holy Spirit is already opening up other doors. What we have to do is kind of be wise and learn St. Ignatius's rules for kind of discerning things. Wise about how do we recognize when that door's being open? The first thing, I would say in recognizing it is, doors open and sometimes we shut them before, the Holy Spirit can even invite us through. We'll say, oh, that door's not for me, okay, I lost this job, but I'm not going to take this other job because I know somebody just offered it, but that's not me, that's not for me. My one thought is, when real opportunities happen to us in times of suffering, in times of loss, whatever we do, don't close the door before the Holy Spirit has a chance to invite us through the door. Mm-hmm. So how do we know when the Holy Spirit's inviting us through the door? Normally that happens through consolation. Mm-hmm. So, you're going to see that there are these little moments of consolation that actually take place. And sometimes it feels like energy. You're being pulled towards something, right? Mm-hmm. Sometimes it feels fascinating. Like all of a sudden you get this real interest in something you really haven't been interested in before. And you're sort of pulled into it a little bit, and you start wanting to read about it. You go, gosh, this is not like me, but I am interested in this thing. Or sometimes it really happens in the form of a kind of peace, almost as if something is drawing you in ever closer. You're going into the light, you're going into the peace, away from the cacophony, away from the darkness, right? And when that happens, again, my thought is, follow those urges. Now, of course, as St. Ignatius says, those have to be tested over the long term. But essentially, you'll see some doors of opportunity open. Whatever we do, let's not slam those doors, because the Holy Spirit may be opening those doors. And when the Spirit does this, normally it's accompanied by some form of peace, some consolation, some kinds of energy, some kind of fascination, as almost as if we're being invited through the door. Of course, the Holy Spirit's not going to push us through the door, and He's going to invite us. And if we kind of go through, and I always just use my little prayer, Lord Jesus, I place my trust in you, so I'm going to go through that door. Then, says St. Ignatius, when you've been through the door for a couple of weeks, just ask yourself, is this kind of fascination, energy, is it still maintaining itself? Are you still wanting to read about this area or do something or investigate this area more fully, right? Is this still happening to you? And of course, secondly, is there something that, are you increasing in trust and hope and love over the long term, or are you decreasing in trust, hope, and love? Trust in God, hope in your salvation, and love. Is that kind of increasing as you move through the door, or is it decreasing as you're moving through the door? If you're decreasing as you're moving through the door, what you want to do is modify that a little bit, right? Or maybe change the direction. But for the Ignatius would say, if the trust level stays the same, the hope level, the love level stays the same or increases, Just keep walking through the door. You're being led, and you're being led by the Holy Spirit into a new opportunity. I can tell you this has happened twice in my life. I won't bore you with the stories, but boy, this technique really does work. So, give it some thought, but I think this is how the Holy Spirit guides us and sometimes guides us into ways of serving people, serving the church, serving the kingdom that we never would have thought of before. You know, my mantra when I was a young kid in college was, I'm no saint, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, let God choose a saint, you know. I always got myself off the hook, you know, until I read this book, The Making of a Saint, in which case he says, you really ought to be asking, you know, that God make you a saint and to help you to want to be a saint. Oh, rats, I got rid of that excuse. And eventually I had to start, you know, looking for the opportunities. And those, I'm telling you, it really, the Holy Spirit leads us. The Holy Spirit is present. He is opening the doors of opportunity. The opportunities will come. Somebody will say something. You'll hear something on the television. I mean, you'll read something, right? You'll be present to another conversation having nothing to do with you. And bada bing, bada boom, you know, suddenly, you know, you're going to click and you go, huh, I wonder. That's the point at which to look for those signs of being drawn in. And then, of course, those confirming signs of same level or increase of trust and hope and love.